Hi, welcome back around the drum. This is Pixel Pro Audio Unfiltered. We are back in the Pixel Pro Audio Studios. I'm your host, Tay. This is David, and that's Jay. This is episode 2, and we're just hanging out, getting ready for the holidays. How are you guys doing?
Good, yourself?
Great.
Good.
Have you guys heard any good news lately about any audio gear coming out?
I'm still on that warm audio kick, 15% off. That's tempting.
Yeah? Are you going to pull the trigger?
I'm kind of thinking about another 1176.
Another one? So you have one right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
I love that thing.
All right.
Yeah. What about you?
In terms of like new stuff coming out?
Sure. Like what do you got?
I think that before we started recording today, we kind of were looking up some of the new things coming out. And I think the thing that excited us the most was the... what's it called? The RodeCaster?
RodeCaster Pro.
Tay will put that up right here.
No, yeah. No, don't do that. I had to make some magic happen last episode.
With the floating Clarett.
So never do this with your hand anymore.
RodeCaster.
Who would do that?
Okay, so it's the RodeCaster Pro.
Right.
Which looks pretty cool.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be a microphone.
Yeah.
And I kind of just assumed it was. It's not a microphone at all. It's actually a podcast studio kind of interface, all
tabletop
built into one. It's got four inputs. It's got four headphone outputs.
It's got DSP processing.
Compression, reverb, everything built into it.
And the AFX processors.
AFX processing.
Yeah, and it's got a Bluetooth connection so you can hook up your phone to it.
So you can have call-in.
Take phone calls with it.
Which is awesome.
That is just the coolest thing.
I wish my setup had that. I could take phone calls because that'd be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And maybe we'll get one up here someday and we'll take a phone call from someone.
To me, the best thing about it outside of that was that it was that you can record directly on it. It's got an SD card slot, as well as, I think, USB-C or something. Don't quote me on that, but I think it has USB-C output as well.
Okay.
So it's an interface as well as being able to just do it all in one place, which there aren't a lot of things out there that are, you know, doing that really do it well.
And there's some Zoom products that have you know, internal mics, they have, you know, SD card stuff.
But this looks level above that.
Yeah, it's made specifically for podcasting, and that's very specialized.
It's kind of what people want, and it's mobile, it looks like. You can take it anywhere, put it on any desk or whatever. So
looks like it's about this big. Oh, and it's got the pads on it. It's got eight pads. So if you're doing, I know, hey, you listen to his podcast. He's always got little sound clips.
David and I were talking about that. Like, I want a board. Eventually, it'd be great, a product that had a board with a built-in MIDI controller pad on it.
And this is it.
This has it. So, because I use, and this will get into the next thing. The PreSonus Atom is coming out, or it is out now.
Yep.
And it's this 16 pad MIDI controller that I've been really intrigued about getting my hands on because it also has some transport controls on the sides.
It's like an all in one controller for StudioOne, which is one of our favorite DAWs.
Its main selling feature is that it's really integrated with StudioOne.
Yeah.
Sounds like it'll work with other things too, but I think people who are buying this are StudioOne users.
Yeah, definitely.
And it sounds like it configures itself when you bring up a synthesizer or a plugin,
which is awesome. No messing around with mapping. Like, those days are over. Yeah. It's great. Yeah. That is great.
So this thing intrigues me because I've been leaning towards getting an Akai MPD 218 for a long time to get a physical soundboard pad, which I just figured out in StudioOne how to do a couple months ago. And we'll do a video on it soon.
That's a good idea.
A standalone.
Because I
want to show you guys what I did to figure out how to do an internal soundboard in StudioOne. But this is a physical pad that you can then select. And
so do you not have a pad right now at
no,
all?
No, I literally click it with my mouse.
Oh, okay.
I need an outboard pad to trigger these sound bites. And the RodeCaster Pro has that built in.
Pretty cool. I mean, they really thought of everything you'd want in a podcast. I mean, we haven't used it, obviously, and I have no idea what it costs. It looks like it's going to be pricey, but who knows?
Yeah.
But
I guess we'll find out and then put it on the screen somewhere, huh?
I don't think they've announced the price.
Yeah. Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, it's not out yet. I mean, we can look it up, but I don't think they've announced the price.
Why would Rode announce this now? Is this for the holidays? This is pretty close to the holidays. Why
maybe
wouldn't they
pre-orders?
Save it for NAMM?
Yeah, I would say they don't go to NAMM. So I would say they're probably getting ahead of all of the news cycle. There's going to be so many product announcements coming out, you know, next month. And not next month, but in January, which is almost next month. And I think that they're just like, let's get ahead of this, because this would be the type of product that would win, you know, the NAMM Best in Show Award. Oh, yeah. For sure, because it's just very unique. And
it looks cool, too, which helps.
And, it fills a need, I think.
Yeah.
So the pre-Sonos Atom did the same thing for me, an outboard MIDI controller pad, MPD 218 would do it, too. But that's what I was looking for, and I'm looking for, and probably sooner than later, that's what I'm going to be getting. So I do want to get my hands on that, on the pre-Sonos Atom, and figure out if that will do what I would like it to do, and do it easily enough, because I just want something that I can plug in USB and load my samples up and literally just hit the button.
Yeah. If anybody's got the Atom yet, leave some comments what you think, and tell them if you should buy it or not.
Because I'm weighing my options right now. I've got a couple choices to go with, and the price points are relatively the same. So I'm looking for functionality and I guess ease of use. So
And what's next on news? I kind of just briefly want to talk about the new Steinberg interfaces.
Sure. Okay.
We don't carry them, but I just think it's either interesting or gimmicky or
why did they attract our attention? Tell me that.
Well, they put a Rupert Neve transformer in the box. Okay.
Rupert Neve Designs. So I can't talk. It's possible he didn't even design that. It's just that company name.
We don't know. Yeah.
All speculation. We have no idea, but it's good marketing.
Yes. And I mean, on the positive side, I think it is cool that they're putting input transformers in recording interfaces. That's a good thing. That's not a bad thing.
Yeah. I've been wanting that for years. I thought that was amazing that someone finally did that.
And the interfaces are kind of pricey, but, you know, the reason people aren't putting transformers in interfaces is because transformers are expensive.
Right.
So we'll see if the proof's in the pudding with these.
Yeah. I saw some reviews like on Sweetwater and other places, and, there's not much out there, but so far it seems pretty positive. Okay. I mean, to put it in perspective, like they've got what is essentially like a Scarlett 2i2 style interface. So two input, two output. And, the Scarlett is $159.
Yeah.
This is $350. So it's a pretty big price hike. Mm-hmm. And the main thing you're getting are two transformers.
And they come with Cubase, right? Yeah, because it's Steinberg.
It's got to be,
probably. And Cubase 10 is out. We don't sell Cubase either, but we've heard nothing but good things about Cubase 10, so...
Okay, so the new interface.
Yeah, we don't know much about that. So
from Steinberg.
I don't have much to say about it.
It comes with the Rupert Neve transformer or design transformer. Yeah. And, good for them and getting Neve's name on their stuff. Yeah. Whether, like I said, the proof will be in the reviews and actually using it to see if it's something of significance. We've kind of seen big names getting put with kind of redesigned items. So we've got the Rupert Neve Steinberg interface, but we also have seen the CLAs, Aventone, I guess NS10 remakes what do you call them?
Which I think are pretty cool.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that for that price point, because what are they, $700?
Yeah, $699.
$699. That's cheaper than what used NS10s were going for.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So I think that's that price point.
For a brand new
set. Yeah.
With a warranty, like, you can't beat that.
Yeah.
It's really good. And it's the exact same design, except the only difference is the connections in the back are just higher quality. Yeah. So
that's kind of cool. Yeah. So
and Avantone is known for having high quality stuff. So I think it's a pretty cool thing that they've done.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so they've gotten a big name to go along with some of their products. So maybe we'll see more of that. I don't know what other big names are out there that you could tie into or grab a hold of, but clearly Neve is one of the best and top ones. So we'll see
if that probably works is out. The best name to put on here.
yep. Yeah.
So those are things that are coming out and that we've been checking out lately. But what else do you guys got?
I think that's it for news.
Yeah, that's more than I thought we'd talk about.
Yeah.
Okay. With the approaching holiday season coming up, we get a lot of questions about what is a good starter interface for someone. And it's usually we get questions from parents or guardians or godparents or grandparents looking to give their loved ones something to use to record, you know, guitar, vocals, you know, rap, whatever they're doing, what can they use to record themselves? So let me ask you guys if you have any suggestions, a good starter.
First, you know, why did you laugh at him saying rap?
Yeah.
It's just funny.
Because you were picturing him.
Yeah, actually. Yes.
Yeah. I don't really get into rap, but I used to. So,
some of it.
Well, clearly with my Farrah Fawcett hair, I'm sure you guys were on to me from the beginning. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, sorry I interrupted with that.
Yeah. So this comes up a lot. What's a good starting recording kit for not a lot of money? Looking to start a studio for less than $500, it's really easy. It's never been easier. My number one recommendation for this kind of thing is the PreSonus Audio Box USB 96 Studio. It's a two-channel interface, and that audio interface connects to your computer, and that's what you plug your microphones in. It gets the sound from your microphones into your computer. So then this kit comes with the interface, a microphone, headphones, and even recording software, really good recording software called StudioOne for you to get started with.
And I think that's the biggest selling point of this package to me is that the software that comes with this, the StudioOne software, is quite a bit better than I think what comes with other interfaces.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's just much more feature-ish, rich. You can do a lot more with it. Yeah.
And the software alone is $100, and they're giving it to you for free with this kit.
Right. Right. So I think our best seller during this season for this type of customer is the Scarlett Solo Studio, which is another great package. It's a single channel interface. And I think that is $219.99. It comes with the microphone, headphones, and a decent quality microphone, headphones, and the interface.
Okay.
As well as some starter software. It comes with, actually, the selling point on the Focusrite side is that it comes with a lot of plugins, including some really good Novation synthesizer plugins and
some soft tube ones.
So for PreSonus, I feel like the software package for the recording software is a little bit better.
Yeah.
And for Focusrite, I feel like you're getting more plugins and synthesizers. So it's kind of a balancing act. What do you, you know,
right?
What do you want more of?
Right.
Yeah. Okay. Great. That sounds good. You know, there are a lot of other options out there, but these are two really, really good ones, starter ones, and
are most popular by far.
Yeah.
So great. And I think that'll wrap it up for this week's episode.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching Pixel Pro Audio's Unfiltered episode 2. I'll be back with my fancy hair, and David will be back with his Hermes hat.
Can you put your hair on here? Put your head on there? Yeah.
Jay will be back with his newsy hat. So,
yeah. Is that newsy?
I like that. So, thanks for watching, and we'll see you around the drum next time.